Check, check. Yeah, kind of low though. Check, check. Much better.
Hello, and ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Veterans Memorial Stadium at the site of Troy University as we have the Class 2A AISA State Championship game between the Escambia Cougars, Escambia Academy Cougars, and the Autauga Academy Generals. AISA has high expectations for our events and the manner in which they are conducted. We are proud of the high level of sportsmanship and character displayed by our students, parents, supporters, and teams. Thank you for your support.
I'm not worried so much with this as I am the rest of the system. As long as we've got that, I really don't care what this does.
Mr. White, did she come get a pad? Did Coach Brown's wife come up here?
Yeah, she's got the pad.
Yes.
She did? So we're good? I just want to make sure.
Yeah, send her hands. We ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
Welcome, Cougar fans. This is Ben White, along with Tim Dewar and Jordan Teak. Today we got extra help. Jordan helped us earlier in the season with a broadcast. Now we've done drafted him in, and now he's part of the team. So,
good morning, sir. Thank you.
You need to turn your mic up a little, Jordan. This is November the 16th, 2018, the matchup between the top two teams in AISA 2A football for the state championship.
Is that better?
Here.
Yeah, better.
Much better. At Veterans Memorial Field, or Veterans Memorial Stadium here in beautiful Troy, Alabama. Temperature right now is about 58 degrees. Slight wind out of the northwest, about 7 miles per hour. We are standing on the visitor side, which is the east side of the stadium. Right now, the boys have went out. The captains of tonight's team for the Cougars is going to be number 35, Jabo Davis. Number 8, Patrick McGee. Number 54, Nolan Lineman. And number 11, Jade Dahl. Looks like they've just got finished with the coin toss. Autauga Academy has won the toss and is elected to receive. Autauga's coming into today's game at a record of 11 wins and 1 losses, 5-0 in regional play. Escambia Academy Cougars coming in with 10 wins and 2 losses and 5-0 in regional. This is the final game of the year for both teams. Many a senior, this will be their last game of their career. So we're going to leave it all on the line today. Hopefully this will be a hard-fought game for both teams. Of course, we're actually pulling for Escambia Academy Cougars to pull it out.
Naturally.
In the end. So we'll wait for the signal, and the Cougars will come busting through their Escambia Cougar banner up on the south goal line. And then up under the mural that's being held by the cheerleaders who are stacked on top of each other out there around the 20-yard line.
We have any Cougar fans there? Woo! Troy University, let's get Troy University a big round of applause for all of this.
Can we up our volume, Tim? Check back with radio. I just upped the volume. How's the sound feel? Check, check.
Now he's not going to be able to hear them probably very good. That's maybe what he's...
I got you. Yeah, he may be talking about the speakers. Great. Right, there we go. Good. Right now we're waiting on the pregame activities to finish it before the Cougars will run out and take the field. No, you. Am I still too low, Phil?
We're all the same volume.
Check, check. Check, 1, 2, 3.
Sounds good on Facebook on this one.
Okay, good.
I mean, I can't.
I think we're good now. Still waiting the pregame festivities.
I'm not worried about the time. I mean, it's probably too much to deal with, but you can't.
We got some squeaking going on.
It's me.
Still waiting the pregame festivities. Let's pray.
Welcome, Cougar fans. We are joining, or we are broadcasting live from Veterans Memorial Stadium here in beautiful Troy, Alabama. Today's matchup is between the Escambia Academy Cougars and the Autauga Academy Generals. Autauga Academy coming in today's game with 11 wins, 1 loss. Escambia Academy coming in with 10 wins, 2 losses. Both teams come in with 5-0 record for regional play. This is the last of the AISA playoff games. This is all or nothing.
Here comes the Cougars.
Here comes the Cougars. Prior to pregame festivities, the Cougars and the Generals have already had the coin toss. The Generals won the toss and have elected to receive to start the game. I would like to bring up a point, Tim. We've got an extra member here today. with the broadcast team, it's usually me, Ben White, and Tim Dewar. But today we got Jordan Teague. Jordan, if you remember, he filled in one time for Tim when he was out.
He wouldn't talk.
He wouldn't say nothing.
Forced him to put a headset on today.
Literally forced.
So we're gonna talk. We're gonna talk to Jordan today and make him say something anyway.
And folks, we've got the sun directly in our eyes, so bear with us as we get that glare gone throughout the gameplay. We are kicking off first tonight, and here we go, all or nothing.
Orlando Medina back to kickoff for the Escambia Academy Cougars. Back to receive for the Generals is number 7, Chris Chapman, and number 33, Josh. Josh takes it right up the middle. Gets hit at the 30-yard line and brought down by several Cougars. I think it was number 3 of the Cougars that brought him down. Well, credit, that's Landon Sims. So the Generals will start their first series of today's ball game, the final state championship ball game, on the 31-yard line, far side hash mark. Quarterback in for the Generals today is number 2, Trip Carr. Back at fullback is Josh Kinsley. Two wideouts on the near side. Oops. Back to the motion. Got man out in motion. Got stacked twins on this side, near side. Tosses number 33 on the screen pass. Hit at the 30-yard line and brought down immediately by a host of Cougars. That looks like number 6, Tyquell Taylor, and number 8, Patrick McGee. I think also Bryant Quimby was in on that. No, it's Cameron Bowen, number 9. So the Generals, single wide out to the near side, wide out to the far side. Manny in motion, hands off around the near side to number 20. It's brought down just after it crosses the line of scrimmage for about a 4-yard gain.
Dalton McGee in there, tripping him up.
That's Darren Ashley, the runner. Third down, 6 yards to go from the shotgun. Carr, hands off. No, fakes, keeps it. Quarterback keeping around the far side end. Crosses the line of scrimmage, fall forward for about a 3-yard gain on that play. Looks like he may be brought down somewhere around that 48-yard line. It appears from where the referee is marking it. That's where he's spotting it, right on the 38-yard line. Got to make it to the 41.
Fourth and 3.
Fourth down, 3 yards to go. Looks like the General's going for it. They got trips on the far side. Twins on the far side. Single back in the backfield. That's number 11, Trey Cutler, behind Carr. Carr's going to hand off to Trey Cutler up the middle. He's going to bring it around the near side in. He breaks it loose. He crosses the 50 to the 40, to the 30, to the 20. Gets knocked into the end zone. Touchdown early in the game. A number 11, Trey Cutler. Touchdown, Generals. So at fourth down and 3, Trey Carr hands off to Trey Cutler. Trip Carr hands off to Trey Cutler. Brings it around the end, runs it in for the touchdown. 10 minutes, 2 seconds showing on the clock, first quarter. Generals looks like they're going to go for 2 this time. Carr going up, direct snap to number 33 right up the middle. He's going to take it in for the 2-point conversion. It's good. That's going to tack on 2 more. So Autauga starts with their first series, ending up with 8 points.
They're aggressive.
Very aggressive, apparently. 8 points. 10 minutes, 2 seconds. Four on the clock, first quarter.
May just,
final game of the season.
May just be me.
Try again.
What's that?
Yeah, it's just really low on his. I don't. We'll look into it.
Kick off. Back to receive for the Cougars. It's going to be number 8, Patrick McGee, and number 1, Lolo Wheat. Number three, Luke Palmer, set to kick off for the Generals. Here's the whistle, Palmer looking back. Here's the approach. Here's the kick. Short pooch kick. Gonna be fielded by Lolo Wheat at the 30-yard line. He's gonna take it down to the far side end, get hit immediately, bringing out to the 36-yard line, where he is brought down.
Will take over 37-yard line.
So the Cougars will start their first offensive drive. First down and 10 from their own 37-yard line.
Excuse me. Made a first few good defensive plays there, and then we just kind of got wide open.
Cougar showing stat trip on the far side. Gabe Dahl, he's quarterback at shotgun. Flanked to his left by running back Patrick McGee. Quick screen pass to Lolo Wheat on the far side. Lolo Wheat
got
a about
nine.
The 40 to the 44-yard line where he's brought down. At the edge of the sideline. I'm not sure if he got out or stayed in.
We're walking backwards. Must be against us.
There's a flag on the flag. I see that.
Talked about that last week. Had to keep our flags down today. Both these teams want it. It's going to be who can keep the penalties down and make plays.
Autauga coming in pretty aggressive. Last year, Escambia Academy Cougars.
We declined it. Chop block. Nope. I'm confused. It was against us way back.
Escambia Academy Cougars took the game from last year. Took first place.
I think it was holding.
Holding.
They've been wanting to get back at the Cougars ever since. This is the first opportunity this has had to meet them. The Cougars are ready to answer. So the Cougars now. First down, 28.
First and 28.
First and 28. There we go. Patrick McGee from the Wildcat. He's bringing it on the near side end. Got a good block by Tebow. Knocks a man down. Pushes another. Finally hit by two or three and brought down at the 27-yard line. He'll pick up nine on that play.
Rush of 11 yards to the standing 30-yard line.
We're looking straight into that sun as it starts to set behind the stadium. Second down, 17. Ball's now on the 30-yard line. 9 minutes, 15 seconds coming on the clock. Cougars have Chase Bell, Lolo Wheat wide out to the far side. Dahl going in the center, backs in the I formation. Dahl taking the snap. Looking to pass.
Slant? No.
Trying to hit Chase Bell over on the far side on that slant pattern. Cougars looking for a pass interference. Not happening. Incomplete pass. Bring
up
third down at 17.
Now, these officiating crew are mic'd up, so they're talking back and forth. Maybe we'll get cleaned up here in a little bit.
Jay Dahl looking back at coach to get the play. Looks like Lolo Weeks going to be far wide out on the far side. Chase Bell's going to be wide out on the near side. Back in McGee and Diego Davis in the I formation. Dahl under center. Bell now in motion toward the far side. Dahl handing off Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee brings it over the near side tackle. He fights off a couple of attackers and makes it all the way out near the first down marker. Actually,
he's going to be about 2 yards short.
Well, it looks like where the refs marking is going to be about 4 yards short.
Wow.
From where we were looking at the left, about 2 yards. The refs marked about a couple more yards. It's going to be 4th and 5.
Here we go. Check this out. I saw some of this in the pre-practice. This is going to be very confusing. Watch this. Timeout called by Autauga. They did not like that at all.
Autauga used their first timeout of the ball game. They'll take 65 seconds. They'll take 60 seconds to head back to WBZR 105.9. For the benefit of those watching here on Facebook Live, we're about to start. Take a minute and go ahead and thank their sponsors for the first time. That's Alabama Tank, Johnson Ford, the United Bank, Deere Technology, Dr. William Harris, General Surgeon, Superior Petroleum Services, Reynolds Real Estate, Diamond Gasoline, David's Catfish House, and David's Paint and Body. Tim, there's two ways to listen to the live broadcast. You want to talk about those a second?
Of course, Facebook, that the majority of our folks are watching on, and we're sending it to the NFHS, but I think folks are having issues logging to the NFHS recently, so we're sending it to them. It'll be on there for archive purposes, but we're going to use this as our primary feed. And, of course, to the radio.
WBZR 105.9, of course, you're listening live. Looks like the Cougars will show punt this time. So, fourth down and five. Ball on the 42. Standing back to punt, number nine, Cameron Bowen. Standing on his own 27-yard line. Back to receive for the Generals is their number seven. Beautiful spiraling punt. Going to hit about the 32-yard line. Take a Cougar roll all the way down inside the 22, the 17-yard line. It's up maybe 18. We'll end up behind it.
Autauga will take that.
Great punt by the Cougars.
8:48.
Folks are chiming in on Facebook that we don't sound good. I'm not sure what the deal is. What I'm listening to sounds okay. You can go ahead and talk and listen in.
So the Generals are going to start this next drive deep inside their own territory. First down and 10 on their own 18-yard line. Trip Carr back from the shotgun. Twins on the far side. Carr flanked to his left by his running back. Hands off, number 20.
Play action.
Oh, play action pass, looking deep. Overthrown, number 8. Well covered by Lolo Wheat, but number 8 was Barry Womack, the intended receiver. Pass was just a little overthrown. A great play action by Trip Carr and his running back. Darion Ashley. After that incomplete pass, it'll be second down and 10. Ball still on the 18-yard line. Wait a minute. It looks like there must have been a penalty I didn't see. It's backed them up to the 13-yard line. Didn't catch the penalty, so it's first down.
It's first and 20.
And 20 from their own 13-yard line. This time the Generals are showing twins to the near side.
Need to get somebody over here to cover the wide receivers. There we go.
Single back in the backfield. Referees are stopping the clock. We'll see what they're talking about.
I think they're going to, I'm not sure what's going on here.
No flag thrown.
No, move the ball. Move the ball 3 inches.
Yeah.
Yeah, the line judge decided he didn't like exactly where the ball was sitting, so he took some time to adjust. First down and 20. Ball's on the 8-yard line. General showing twins to the near side this time. Single back. Flanked. Oh, there's going to be a reverse play this time. Number 7 around the far side end. Blocked. Still on his feet. Spinning. Brings it across the 15-yard line to the 17-yard line where he's knocked down by a host of Cougars. And I think he's actually knocked out of bounds. That'll be a 9-yard carry for the Generals. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball's on the 18-yard line now. Trips on the near side, single out at the far side. Carr from the shotgun, flanked to his left by the running back. Back in the pocket, looking to pass. Off in the, on the five and out pattern, number 5 was the intended receiver, just off the fingertips, incomplete pass. That was number 5, Turner Payton for the Generals, the intended receiver. Just a little bit too high for him. Third down and 10 now. Ball on the 18. 7 minutes, 13 seconds on the clock, first quarter. Autauga drawing first blood with a score of 8-0.
We're kind of slow to get over to the defenders. Or the offense there. Wide receivers are wide open. Too much space.
Stack twins on this side. Twins on the far side, too. Looks like there's pressure as Carter looking to pass down deep. Got a man open. Just overthrew it. Incomplete pass. Number 8 trying to make the adjustment. Got his hands on it, but just couldn't quite hold on to it. Carter under pressure.
That was a pretty good throw under duress.
It was. He's been mentioned in the past by some other orders as the mini version of Johnny Manziel. He scats all over the field.
And I did have a chance to watch some video this past week. Fourth down and 10 on the 18. Looks like the Generals are going to punt it away. Or show punt, nonetheless.
Yeah, you never know.
They do have a wide out to the far side. Here's a snap. Here's the low punt. Going to hit about the 48-yard line. Roll across the 50, across the 45, the 40. Now it's to the 35. Where it's going to be downed by number 6. That will be Devontae Mays.
I want to give a shout out to Sands Tech LLC. Jordan's actually employed with them. He's with us today, though. They do a lot of video production systems, churches, and different organizations. Great job. They actually do some stuff for another company I work for as well. And glad they're here to help us out today.
Cougars now have it, first and 10 on their own 35-yard line. Trips on the near side. Looks like Patrick McGee from the Wildcats. He'll bring it around the near side end. Got a stiff arm as he tries to go around the end. Horse collar. Looks like it's going to be what the call is going to be.
Might be a face mask.
Face mask or horse collar. One of the two.
I saw the hand on the horse collar when the flag came out, and I bet that's what it is. But I have been wrong before. So, McGee does scramble forward to the line of scrimmage where he's brought down, but the flags are flying everywhere, so it should go our way.
Coach doesn't look upset, so it must be in our favor. Coach Hugh Fountain on the left, Mike Sims in the middle, Martino on the right. I don't know, here a lot of discussion. I mean, if it was a simple double flag, what happened there? I'm looking for the white hat.
Can't see the call hardly from this side.
False start.
False start against the Cougars.
And then face mask
against the Generals.
Offset. So we'll just move on. Nope.
That's not offsetting. The offside.
Oh, there was 2 on
there. Maybe 15 for the Generals.
So what happened? Nothing. A lot of talk. A lot of flags. Ball doesn't move.
Okay. Tyree Smith now wide out for the Cougars. Chase Bell wide out to the near side. Tyrese is on the far side, Chase Bell on the near side. Patrick McGee, J-Bo in an I formation. Dahl going under center. First down 10, 35-yard line, 6 minutes. Now Bell now in motion towards the far side. Dahl hands off Patrick McGee around the near side tackle. He runs across through, hits a couple of guys. What a hit. Fights his way out to the 45-yard line, close to that first down marker. We'll see what the ref says once it's spotted, but it's awful close.
Looks like second.
Yep, second and
second and inches.
Inches.
Tip of that ball is right on that 45-yard line. I think now got to get about another foot. Tyree Smith wide out far side. Chase Bell wide out near side. Backs, I formation, Dahl under center. Hands off J-Bo right up the middle. J-Bo's going to cross that 45-yard line to the 46. That should be enough for the first down, and the chain should move. Give the Cougars another set of downs to work with.
Looks like they did move the chains last play, so that was first down.
My mic is breaking up, is what they're saying. Why are they showing second down?
They did move the chains last play. They did it right at the last second.
Okay, second down and 9. Tyree Smith, wide out far side. Lolo Wheat, wide out near side. Dahl looking to pass and tackled in the backfield. That's going to be a sack. Knocked down around that 40-yard line. That's a big loss for the Cougars.
I can't hear it. It sounds perfect.
Looks like it's going to be third down to 15 now. The ball is on the 40-yard line. 5 minutes, 5 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Tyree Smith, wide out far side. Lolo Wheat, wide out near side. Dahl looking back at coach for the call. Looks like Jabo Davis and Patrick McGee are in the I formation. Correction, Jabo looks like he's moving towards that flanker. Patrick McGee is going to flank Jabe Dahl to his left. Here's a snap. Patrick McGee is going to bring him around the near side. He's hit. As he crosses the line of scrimmage, he'll pick up a couple, but that's about it. Going to be fourth down, about 13. Spotting the ball on the 42-yard line. 4 minutes, 32 seconds on the clock. Cameron Bowen back to kick off, or to punt it away for the Cougars. Bowen standing on the 27-yard line. Here's a snap, kick up. Oh, I got a piece of it. It's going to be caught, and Jabo Davis is going to save the touchdown. Knock him down at the 30-yard line. A little bit of pressure on that punt. It come through, got a hand on the punt. The punt got off, but it was just tipped and went straight up. Number 84 for the Generals actually caught it. Trying to run it in. Jabo Davis there to knock him down. Save the touchdown. So the Generals have a great field position this time in Cougar territory. Ball on the 29-yard line. Twins far side. Man now in motion. Carr hands off to number 20. It tries to go across that right side tackle and knock down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that play. Darion Ashley is number 20, the runner. It's actually a 1 yard loss.
Yeah, they're saying he lost a yard.
Second down 11. Ball's now on the 30 yard line. Twins far side. From a shotgun, Carr hands off to 20 around the near side tackle. He breaks across through into the secondary. He's finally hit by a host of Cougars. Stopped at the 20-yard line. I think that's going to be just shy of the first down, but flags come out late. We'll see what the flags are about.
I did not see the hand motion, no.
Football,
shotgun. Main in motion to the far side. Oh, the snap. Looks like he's going to try to keep it. In it. Tries to run up the middle. Let him do it. Tries to come back. Now he's looking to pass. Stop, but still on his feet. In it. Finally hit and brought down. Inside the 15 to about the 12, 13 yard line. We'll see where it's spotted. It looks like it's spotted close to 13.
It's going to be second and eight. That showed off some of that Johnny Manziel comparison. Is that something that they do? It seems like that's what they do.
I don't know why they're going for two every time, but they are. Cutler flanking Carr to his right. Looks like a flag's on the play. I imagine that's going to be some movement in the offensive line. It is. Had to back him up 5 yards.
Think they'll still go for two?
I think they are. Ball now was sitting on about the 7.5 yard line. Autauga going for two. Direct snap to number 33. He's going to try to take it on in, but he's like a stopped and decides to pass it. Flags come out. He may have already crossed that line of scrimmage before he let the ball go.
Looks like it.
Penalty is going to be assessed on the kickoff. All right, so 2 minutes, 24 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Autauga is now leading by a score of 14 to nothing. Time for the Cougars to turn it on and make this ball game much tighter. Coach Fountain down there talking to the Cougars, firing them up, getting them ready. Patrick McGee and Lolo Wheat will be back for the Cougars. Lolo appears to cheat up a little bit this time. The last kick was more of a pooch kick that landed around the 30-yard line on the far side. Patrick McGee playing in the center of the field, standing on about the 14-yard line. Luke Palmer set to kick it away for the Generals. Here's the approach. Another pooch kick. Called by Chase Bell. He's going to take it up the middle. Crosses the 40 to the 41-yard line. 42-yard line if we're brought down. And that's where the ball will be spotted. And that's where the Cougars will start their next offensive series. First down 10 from their own 42-yard line. Cougars taking two early hits in this game, Tim. It's time for the Cougars to go ahead and take a hit of their own, right?
Sorry. Been working on audio.
I'm sorry.
I have no clue what you said.
We got Chase Bell wide out to the near side, which is now in motion. Dahl under center, backs in the I formation. Dahl handing off to Patrick McGee, tries to bounce it around the far side end. He may cross that line of scrimmage and get a yard, but not much more. Second down and 9. Ball is going to be on the 43-yard line. Clock now under 2 minutes for the first quarter. Chase Bell wide out on the near side. J-Bo Davis going to flank Dahl on his right side now. Patrick McGee behind him in the pistol formation. Here's a snap. Dahl looking to pass real quick. Had Chase Bell, his 10 receiver, over on that five and out pattern. Incomplete pass. That's going to be third down and 9. Ball will stay on the 43-yard line with 1 minute 32 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Tyree Smith's going to be wide out to the far side. Bell wide out the near side. Dahl staying in the shotgun formation this time. Backs are going to flank him, flank Dahl both sides. Dahl looking to pass downfield this time. Got looking for Chase Bell. Chase Bell hits it. It was a high pass. Bell able to jump up, tap it, trying to bring it down. Oh, excuse me, that was Lolo Wheat. Unfortunately, could not put it in. The pass was just a little too high. Thought there may have been a little bit of defensive pass interference on that play, but apparently the referees didn't feel the same way. Fourth down and 10, ball on the 43-yard line. Cougars will have to punt it away once again. Cameron Bowen back to punt for the Cougars. Last time the Cougars punted, they got the Generals actually got a piece of it, blocked it, and put them in great field position.
They got close again.
Got close. Calling for fair catch was number 7 for the Generals. That was Chris Chapman back at the 26-yard line.
Having a hard time following that ball, that sun. So
that sun is difficult.
You may have missed some of that on the video. But about another 5 minutes, that sun will be out of here.
So the Generals will start their next series from their own 26-yard line. Ball on the far side hash mark. First down and 10. One minute, 12 seconds on the clock for the first quarter. Autauga showing twins in the near side. Single back in the backfield behind Carr. Carr's going to hand off. He's going to keep it. Try to run up the middle. He's got some room. He found a hole. Still on his feet. Brings across to the 40, to the 30, to the 20, to 10. He's going to make it into the end zone for the touchdown. There's a flag back on the field, though, back at the 31-yard line. We'll see what that's about. This one may be coming back.
Might have been holding. Or walking the back.
That's probably going to be the case from where that flag was. That touchdown's probably coming back. I don't know what the call was.
Touchdown. Yeah.
Must have been a holding because the touchdown was awarded. That's going to put a target 20 points.
It's a heck of a run.
That it was. Target going for 2 once again. Flags to come out. The illegal substitution being the call against the Generals. That'll back them up 5 yards. Seconds showing on the clock, first quarter. Autauga already hitting the end zone 3 times. Going for 2. Trip Carr from the shotgun. Looking to pass, back in the pocket, looking. Got a man open at the end zone, not able to catch it though. Incomplete pass, that's going to be Lolo Wheat covering him. Excuse me, Tyree Smith, number 7. So the score will remain 20-0, 55 seconds left on the clock for the first quarter. Autauga Generals leading the Escambia Academy Cougars
quiet on this side of our, of this field. Fans aren't into it. We'll have them up here in a minute.
We just need Patrick McGee to break us and take it all the way back to the house and get the fans and the players back into it. Now, last year, Tim, the Cougars had to come back from behind to win.
Autauga had to come back from behind. You know, we got up first. You said, yeah. EA got up first.
Okay.
Yeah, and Autauga had to come back. Yeah, that's how it was. And they almost got us. I think we were up by 12 points in the first quarter.
So now Autauga kicked off from the Cougar 45-yard line. Looks like Dalton McGee is going to pick it up at the 15. And brought down immediately. I really wish I could see the call from the ref, because I have no idea what all just happened to make.
I'm not for sure. That sun's in about another 2 minutes will be gone.
Well, oftentimes he's making the call with his back to us.
Yeah, that's not super helpful. We're not seeing these calls.
All right, so the Cougars have it. First down and 10 from the 16-yard line, excuse me. Looks like Patrick McGee is in the Wildcat formation. Single wide out near side. Dalton McGee coming to motion. Patrick keeps it, tries to take it around the end, hitting the backfield, and brought down around the 11-yard line. It's going to be about a 5-yard loss on that play.
Number 71 for Autauga is getting up kind of slow.
Second down.
And 14.
Second down, 14. Ball's on the 12-yard line.
I'm just going to let the clock run down in the first quarter.
That'll do it the first quarter. So at the end of the first quarter, the Autauga Generals are leading Escambia Academy Cougars by a score of 20-0. Let's get the teams to flip sides of the field and see if the EA can't answer that 20 points and put a few extra on the board by halftime. While they're doing that, we're going to take a second and thank our sponsors. Also take 60 seconds, head back to WBZR 105.9. Our sponsors today, Alabama Tank, Johnson Ford, United Bank, Dewar Technology, Dr. William Harris, General Surgeon, Superior Petroleum Services, Reynolds Real Estate, Diamond Gasoline, David's Catfish House, and David's Paint and Body. You see these guys around town, go tell them thank you. Go buy their business, do business with them. They make it possible for us to bring this live broadcast to you each and every Friday evening. Sun's now finally starting to dip behind that southern stands now.
Sun is gone.
So we'll be able to see a little
better.
Bit.
Sun is gone. Sun is gone.
Thank you.
I can see. I like to move the camera 3 inches.
Come on, let's go.
But the temperature dropped about 5 degrees in about a minute and a half as well. So, start the second quarter. Cougars have the ball. Second down, 14 on the 12-yard line.
Get the plan. Let's go.
Jabe Dahl in the shotgun. Pistol formation. Twins on the near side now. We got Chase Bell in motion towards the far side. Jabe Dahl looking to pass. Got pressure rolling out of the near side. Throws. Hits Bell across the middle. Bell can't hold on to the pass. Incomplete. I don't think Bell was the intended receiver. He was just sticking to him.
I think he wanted to go deep on the sideline there, and just it covered. Just wasn't there.
That's incomplete. Brings up third down and 14. Tyree Smith and Lolo Wheat wide out on the near side this time.
There we go.
Dahl looking back at coach, finally getting to play. J-Bo Davis lining up that flanker. Looking to pass. He's rolling out the near side. Dahl look, hits Shannon Wheat or Lolo Wheat at the 15. Lolo still on his feet, brings it out to the 19-yard line, for which finally brought down by about half the Generals team.
That's about an accurate description.
He was. There wasn't but three Generals left not on this side of the field.
Two flags on the play, offsetting.
Still not sure what the cause was. Like the ball will remain on the 19-yard line. That'll make it fourth down and 7 from the 19. Cameron Bowen will have to punt it away once again, this time standing on his own 5-yard line. Generals have been getting penetration back there and putting a lot of pressure on Bowen. Bowen's got to get it off fast, particularly way back near his own goal line. Here's a snap. Snaps up. Good punt this time. Nice spiraling punt's going to hit around that 43-yard line and bounce across the 40, 35, and keep rolling to the 31-yard line where it's finally going to be touched.
We have a flag back here on the 15-yard line.
Another flag. So we'll see.
Put it in your pocket!
We're kind of close to the fans' hopes.
Been a lot of flags so far.
Seems to be, sometimes. We're gonna re-kick it.
Still not sure what the flag was about.
I like, they've got these radios, but they're still running to tell each other. I'm confused. Do they not work? Are they for looks?
They're purely aesthetic, yeah.
Probably the two most premier teams in this region, or this division, 2A, is us and Autauga. 2016, they defeated us. 2017, we defeated them. And we're back again.
Okay, so the flag must have been against the Generals. That'll give the Cougars a first down. I don't know what the flag was. We'll take it, though. It wasn't the right direction. Tyree Smith going to be wide out on the near side. The ball's first down and 10 on the 34 now. 11 minutes left to go in the half. Chase Bell wide out far side. Dahl under center. Backs out formation. Handoff. Patrick McGee hitting the backfield. Hit again. Spins him off. Still on his feet. Finally fights forward back to the line of scrimmage. Looks like there's not going to be a gain on that play. But Patrick fought hard and long to not lose anything because he got hit about 2 yards back.
Their defense is swarming.
Some bad bees.
Defense definitely putting the pressure back in the backfield. Wideouts both sides. Dahl under center this time. Backs, eye formation. Looks like we may have an offsides penalty called against Autauga. If Cougar didn't move, and that's where they're going to mark
yep.
it. So that'd be an extra 5 yards to help the Cougars out. Ball will now be on the 40-yard line. Make it second down and 4 to go. 10 minutes, 9 seconds on the clock. Tyree Smith wide out near side. Bell far side. Dahl under center. Jabo Davis, Patrick McGee in the I formation. Here's a snap. Dahl handing to Patrick McGee over the far side tackle. He fights forward, and fights to the 45-yard line. That'll be enough for the first down, and the chains will move. Patrick has had to fight for every yard he's got today, Tim.
Yes, it's going to be that way. You have number one in our region, number two in our region playing each other. Of course, Autauga is ranked number one in the state. We're ranked number seven. So it's not going to be a cakewalk. We knew that coming into it. Didn't think the score would be this high so soon.
First and 10 from the 45. Dahl hands off to Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee brings it around the near side. He stiff arms two people, finally brought out to the 49-yard line, where he's brought down.
That was a horrible face mask. I'm surprised he didn't get called. He brought him straight down.
Chase Bell wide out on the far side. Lolo Wheaton near side.
I think someone agreed with you.
Yeah, I think so.
Dahl from the shotgun. Backs are in the pistol formation. Here's a snap. Dahl taken, hand off to McGee. McGee hit as he crosses the line of scrimmage. Plows across that midfield line all the way to the 47-yard line, where he's brought down. Short of the first down. But he picks up three. Actually, ball is going to be spotted on the 48-yard line. Just third down and three to go. 8 minutes, 15 seconds. Bell wide out on the far side. Lolo Wheat near side. Dahl from the shotgun. Hands off to Patrick McGee, hit as he crosses the right guard, and stood up immediately, nothing doing, no gain on the play. Bring up third down and three. Ball will remain on the 48-yard line. Clock's ticking though, 7 minutes, 48 seconds. Autauga still up by 20. Cougars desperately needing to put some points on the board before halftime.
Would you go for it here?
I would. I think Coach is too.
I think you're right.
Fourth down and three. Dahl flanks to his right and his left by his running backs. Single wide out both sides. Dahl looking to pass. Throws. Hit. His intended receiver, Lolo Wheat.
Pass interference.
Pass interference is going to be against Wheat, I imagine, though. It looked like Wheat grabbed him. The pass, it looked like Dahl's pass is a little behind. And I don't disagree with Lolo if it's a call against him. Because if there were an interception that time.
It's on defense.
Well, now, never mind.
I'm waiting to see, is there an offsetting penalty?
Right.
That's been the case every few minutes here.
We'll take it. Pass interference called against the Generals. We'll give the Cougars the first down.
See some EA alumni down there. Too bad you can't suit those guys up and put them in.
First down and 10 on the 38. Cougars have Chase Bell wide out to the far side. Lolo Wink to the near side. Dahl from the shotgun looking to pass. He's throwing it for Bell on the far side. Bell kicks it. Shoulder, ball placed perfectly by Jabe Dahl. Chase Bell reaching out there, cradling it, bringing it in. Great reception by Bell. All the way down at the 9-yard line, that gives the Cougars another first down. First down and goal this time on the 9-yard line, on the 8-yard line, excuse me. And give Cougars some momentum, which we need. At 7 minutes to go in the first half.
I see Jabo.
It's a heck of a catch.
Yeah. A great catch.
I see Jabo running a few yards here.
Dahl under center this time. Single wide out both sides. Dahl handing to Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee tries to go one way, bounces another, hitting the backfield, brought down at the 15-yard line. Had to be about a 6-yard loss.
That play got broken up from the beginning.
It did. It did. The defensive line got through real quick.
Some big old kids on that line. And we got big kids.
Well, their speed is what's impressive. Second down to 15. Ball on the 15. Second down to 15. 6 minutes to go. Wide out. Single wide outs both sides. Dahl from the shotgun. Flanked just right and his left by the running backs. It's going to be Lolo Wheat split wide to the near side. Chase Bell to the far side.
Timeout.
Timeout's going to be called.
They didn't like what we saw. Or was it on? Did we call?
It was our timeout.
Timeout's called by the Cougars. They're going to take 60 seconds to talk about it. We're going to take 60 seconds, head back to WBZR 105.9.
I'm going to adjust this audio so we're not blasting everybody. I think I got it tweaked a while ago. It's cutting in and out. But when we get excited, it does
cut.
It's kind of hard to
get excited. Who gets excited? We'll thank our sponsors while we got a minute to talk about it. Our sponsors, Alabama Tank, Johnson Ford, the United Bank, Dewar Technology, Dr. William Harris, General Surgeon, Superior Petroleum Services, Reynolds Real Estate, Diamond's Gasoline, David's Catfish House, and David's Paint and Body.
Not that we have any numbers. We're adjusting the camera that's got the scoreboard for us. Although we don't have any points on that side of the board yet. I'd still like to get the...
We're fixing to change that, hopefully.
Changing, I hope.
Cougars will be returning. The ball will be second down to 15 on the 15-yard line. 6 minutes left to go in the half. The Cougars are trailing by 20, but threatening. Jabe Dahl going under center. Got Lolo Wheat wide out near side. Bell, far side. Jabo Davis, Patrick McGee in the I formation. Dahl didn't like what he sees. Makes an audible. Here takes a snap. Hands off Patrick McGee. He bounces around the far side and hit at the line of scrimmage and brought down maybe a yard behind the line of scrimmage. Looks like a yard loss on that play. There's a loss of two. Third down, 17 yards on the 17-yard line.
Man, we were picking up their team good. Just our mics are on. There's no boom mic.
Yeah.
Dahl from the shotgun, backs, pistol formation, wide out, single, both sides. Dahl taking a snap, looking to pass, got some pressure. He's scrambling, he's looking. Oh, he gets brought down behind the line of scrimmage around the 24-yard line. I don't see any flags on the ground. That'll be a loss of seven on that sack. Fourth down and goal from the 24-yard line with 4 minutes, 50 seconds. I would put Orlando Medina in there, let him kick a field goal from that point.
True.
Medina can do it.
It's kind of important to get any kind of points. Yeah.
Going for it. Dahl from the shotgun. Chase Bell wide out on the far side. Lolo Wheat to the near side. Jabo Davis flanking to the left. Patrick McGee flanking to the right. Dahl looking to pass. Heading for the end zone. It's going to be intercepted in the end zone by number 8 from the Generals.
Barry Womack.
That's Barry Womack. So 4 minutes, 16 seconds left to go in the half. The Generals will take over first down and 10 from their own 20-yard line. Cougars defense have to hold them here. Tripped Carr from the shotgun, flanked to his right by his running back. Back to pass in the pocket, deep in the pocket, looking deep. Downfield, He hits his man at the 45-yard line. It's caught and brought out to the 49 where he's brought down.
That was number five.
That was number five, Turner Payton. Autauga has first down and 10 now from the 48-yard line. Chains move. Carr looking to pass. Got a man wide open on the far side. Hits him. That was number five again, Payton. He gets hit by number, who's that, 22, Dr. McGee, knocked out of the 30-yard line.
We're not getting set.
We was not over there.
That's the sixth or seventh time we've been wide open like that.
Quick snap block that. Payton was wide open and nobody around him. Fortunately, Dr. McGee playing safety got over and knocked him out of bounds. Carr, oh, fumble in the backfield. Looks like EA may recover this ball.
I think we did.
EA recovered.
There we go. There you go, defense.
Number, I can't read.
That was a bad
59.
Connection between the center and Carr.
Number 59 recovered that.
59.
Or 58, excuse me. I'm not wearing my glasses.
Looks like Jason Helton may have been.
68, there it is.
68.
Close enough.
Tyler Newton.
EA got the ball back.
EA got the ball back. We'll take it. First down and 10 now. Cougars have the ball from the 33-yard line. Tyree Smith going to be wide out the near side. Number three checking in. He's going to be wide out as well. That's Landon Sims. Dawes calling timeout.
Yeah, we weren't ready. Nobody knew what the play was.
They're going to take 6 seconds to talk about it.
Upset.
Should be our last timeout.
3 minutes, 46 seconds left to go in the half. The Cougars used their last timeout. Cougars trailing by a score of 20-0. Hopefully they'll see if they can put some points on the board before halftime. Temperature definitely starting to drop a little bit, Jordan.
I had to put my jacket on.
This is the second time I've had the opportunity to visit Veterans Memorial Stadium here in Troy, Alabama. It is such a beautiful stadium.
Of course, they've added this extension on the back. You know, this was under construction last year and was not here the year I was here in 16. And we lost to Autauga the first go-around. And pretty nice. I think they've got a game tomorrow. Do they have a Friday game? Saturday?
Double check.
They're here, I'm pretty sure. And they're setting tents up outside, I would imagine.
Yeah.
It's kind of nice not having to worry about other scores.
Right.
All right, looks like Cougars are going to show twins on the near side. Single wide out to the far side. Dahl under center, backs in the eye formation. Dahl handing off Patrick McGee over the left side tackle. Hit at the line of scrimmage. Fights forward, maybe gains a yard, but then he stopped and pushed back. Shoe comes off by someone. Looks like it's going to be, who's that? Patrick McGee may have lost a shoe on that. No, it wasn't Patrick. Who was that?
Okay, no.
All right, it looks like a general putting a shoe back on out there. 1 yard gain, second down and 9. Ball on the 34-yard line.
Why is the clock running? We're waiting for somebody to put a shoe.
3 minutes, 12 seconds left to go in the half. Landon Sims and Tyree Smith is wide out to the near side. That's going to be Chase Bell wide out to the far side. Jabo Davis at fullback. Patrick McGee at tailback. Dahl under center. Take the snap, tall sweep around this near side end to Patrick. Patrick McGee gets a great block, crosses the 40 to the 45-yard line, which finally brought down near the 46-yard line. That's enough for the first down. The chains of move, and the Cougars have four more downs to work with. 2 minutes, 44 seconds left to go in the half.
They scored any in the second quarter, or was it all in the first quarter?
There's one in the second.
It's been half the time in the second quarter worrying about this audio. I'm so lost. Glad you're here helping.
Looks like Landon Sims and Chase Bell's wide out the far side this time. Tyree Smith on the near side. Dahl staying under center. Back staying in the eye formation. Hands off. Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee goes right over the center. Gets hit as he crosses the line of scrimmage. Pushes forward for about 4 yards. Looks like he's going to make it all the way out to the 49-yard line based on where the referee has his foot spotted.
Yeah, where's that yellow line at?
Yeah, we need the little yellow line, don't we?
Sorry, I'm not that technical.
Just shy of the 49-yard line. It's a 4-yard gain on the play. It's going to bring up second down to 6.
You've already shot down my pylon cam idea, so.
1 minute, 51 seconds, under the 2 minutes now. Twins near far side, single wide out near side. Backs eye formation, Dahl, toss sweep around the near side end to Patrick. Patrick cuts it across the tackle, stayed on his feet, spins, knocks a few people off, and he's finally stopped and brought down after he crosses midfield around that 47-yard line. So we're just shy of the first down, maybe 2 yards.
He don't like to go down either.
He doesn't.
It's like Trey Turner, final play of last year. Trey just kept driving, 19 yards with people on his back.
Third down and 2. Ball on the 47-yard line. This time we're on the general side of the field, though. We got 1 minute, 9 seconds with the clock ticking. Cougars. Twins the far side, single wide out near side. Backs, I formation, Dahl under center. Clock still ticking, under a minute now. Here's a snap. Hands off to Jabo up the middle. Jabo crosses the 45 to the 43, where he's brought down. That's the first down. So Cougars have a first down and 10 from the 43-yard line. 48 seconds left to go on the clock. Time management is going to be critical here.
With no timeouts.
We sure need those timeouts back. Looks like Daughtry, McGee, and Lolo Weeks going to be wide out the near side. It's going to be Tyree Smith and Chase Bell wide out to the far side. Patrick McGee is going to be the only one left in the backfield to the right of Dahl. Here's a snap. Hands off McGee right the middle. Got a hole. Crosses the 40 to the 35 to the
fumble.
32. A fumble occurs. We'll see who gets it, but it looks like the Generals are claiming it.
He might have been down.
The referees have not made the official call. They're still on the ground struggling.
They're not sure.
The referee now gives a call saying it's Generals ball. So the Generals will receive the ball back with 19 seconds left to go in the half.
I guess the referees don't get to review the footage at this level, huh?
No, they don't.
First and 10 from the 33-yard line, so the Generals will have it.
This is why I'm glad we're down here. They would have had us over here or way over there.
Trip car from the shotgun. Single back in the backfield, deep in the pocket, looking to pass. Hits the man across.
Wide open.
On that, oh, man, wide open. He crosses the 40 to the 30, ahead of the 20. He's taking it home. That's number 33 on that post pattern. He hits in midfield. And he takes it in to make the score 26 to nothing. First play from the line of scrimmage.
We are not playing getting set. We're dragging our feet to get to that other side. That's twice now.
Yeah.
Safeties, I think, maybe tripped up on each other on that play.
They're taking advantage of it, like Peyton Manning.
Yep, he's coming out slinging. Biggest deficit EA has faced all season.
This time, looks like number 11 is going to take it from the Wildcat. He's going to hand off to number 7 and go around the far side end. He will get in, and 2-point conversion is successful. That'll make the score 28 to nothing with 7 seconds left to go in the half. Autauga up by 28. And you could hear a pin drop on the Cougar sideline.
Yes, you can. Those that may be on Facebook chatting in, if y'all can, AISA requires us to keep a, pulled up, just a proper, language terminology. So if we can try to rephrase from anything negative, I mean, I understand that I'm upset right now too, but the AISA Association sees anything negative,
posted about the other team, we'll actually get a $500 fine. So if you can, if I see anything, I'm going to have to remove those comments. I definitely appreciate you chiming in and being supportive of our Cougars, but school doesn't want to have to pay a $500 fine or lose the opportunity to broadcast the future games.
So the Generals will kick it away again. Patrick McGee's going to be back standing on his own 15. Another pooch kick to Dr. McGee over there on the 32-yard line. McGee's going to take it, bring it to the near side. He's got a little room. He's got a couple blockers. He brings it out to the 45, which finally brought down as he run down from behind. Right. That was a flag come flying out.
Yep.
Two flags come flying out. Three flags come flying out.
That would have been the last play of the half, but we might get one.
Time expires. We'll see what the flags are on.
Yep. Very late hit in the back by one of our players. I saw that. Very late hit. This player may, I mean.
Well, time's expired. We'll see if we'll head on to the locker rooms or we'll make some adjustments on the field and put a couple seconds back.
He's going to wave them all off.
All of them will be waved off. That'll do it for the first half of play. So in the AISA championship game, Autauga will go into the halftime leading by a score of Autauga 28, Escambia Academy 0. They'll take 20 minutes for halftime, and we'll take 20 minutes of a break as well. We'll be back in approximately 17 minutes to begin the second half. This is Ben White along with Tim Dewar and Jordan Teak today.
Give it up for the Escambia County varsity cheerleaders.
Folks, we're going to mute the audio, get something to eat, and we'll be back. I'll put a message out there so you can see it as well.
We now welcome on the Escambia
Forgot.
Haley Stone, Hannah Stone, Ruby Nix, and Bama Coburn. Their dancing coach is Mrs. Carolina Smoke.
Stand too close, we'll put a headset on you and interview you since it's your last game.
Special performance from Escambia Academy, majorette Hillary Husky.
I know. Give it up for the Escambia County Varsity Cheerleaders dance team and majorettes.
This is one?
It should be this one.
Yeah, just his game down.
Now on the field is the Autauga Academy Varsity Cheerleaders. AISA All-Star UCA All-American Caroline White. AISA All-Star and Captain Abby Seaman. AISA All-Star Cindy Ashley. Chloe Gulledge, Savannah Harding, Carson Kimso, Dixie McGaylier, Alyssa Montgomery, AISA All-Star Lainey Nichols, AISA All-Star Sarah Norman, Trinity Norman, Cameron Daniel, Hannah Dinkle, Abby Ray, Brooke Sherman, Bailey Smith, Gina Sparks, Madison Williams, UCA All-American. Ansley Henry, Katie White, and Alexis Robbins. Give it up for the Autauga Academy Varsity Cheerleaders. Thank you.
Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Check, 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 check.
Sound good?
Sounds good.
Go back up?
Yep. I'm going to take the headset off so I can listen in.
Check, check.
Mic check.
Not good.
I think I'm going to turn that just a slightly down.
Jordan, got less than a minute now, or just before the second half commences of the AISA championship game here at Veterans Memorial Stadium here in Troy, Alabama. Jordan, first half didn't really go Escambia Academy's way. Most of all the action was on the Autauga side. Autauga putting up.
And any time that Escambia County got close, something went wrong. Interception down in that corner and a lot of penalties and just not a lot of positives.
Yeah, it looks like Autauga may have put up a total yardage of about 290 yards total offensive yardage for Autauga to Escambia Academy's 96. You want to break down the rushing and passing?
Yeah, you're looking at 59 rush yards for Escambia and 173 for Autauga. And passing yards is 117 for Autauga and 37 for Escambia. So virtually in every category, doubling and tripling Escambia's numbers.
Definitely not the numbers we want to see here at halftime. Of course, that reflects on the scoreboard with 28-0, Autauga leading the Escambia Academy. But there's still a whole half of football to play.
It's a long time.
Quite a bit of football and quite a bit of time left to play. So hopefully Coach Fountain's able to get the Cougars fired up and ready to come back and play some serious Cougar football, at least the way we know they can play. Looks like it's short about a minute and 30 before they get ready to kick off again. Tim's up here making some adjustments to all of our equipment. Temperature's really starting to drop. I bet it's probably dropped 10 degrees since that sun went down. People who had all their jackets and mittens tucked away nicely in their bags now have brought them out and put them on.
Looks like we're down to 56 degrees.
56 degrees. Still a slight wind out of that northwest. Feels like it's coming right off an iceberg. Looking towards that northern sky, northwestern sky. It's got that beautiful orange and blue color to it. Reminds me of a college somewhere in this part of the state.
Kind of like Troy.
Troy.
Reserved your tickets for the,
I got to say, I at least got to put one War Eagle in every game, you know?
Oh, here it goes. Facebook is blowing up now. If y'all are on Facebook, I just checked it. Sounded good. Let us know if we need to make any tweaks. We've made some adjustments to kind of help with chipping sounds you may have been hearing.
About 7 seconds left to go before they get prepared to kick it away, kick off, start this third quarter. Tim, me and Jordan were sitting there talking just a moment ago about the total yardage. Autauga's got a 290 total offensive yardage to Escambia Academy's 96. What can we do different in the second half?
Pat McGee's got to get 390 more yards. No, I'm being serious. Pat needs a 400-yard, quick 400 yards, not 5 yards, 5 yards, 5 yards. We make a bad call, you know, as far as defensively or offensively, and the ball gets taken away from us.
Yeah.
He needs a straight 100-yard return, another straight 100-yard return.
It's nice that you don't ask too much.
Yep.
Yeah, that's good.
It would help if Patrick McGee would run this all the way back. That would really help morale, I'm sure. So get ready. The generals get prepared to kick it away to start this third quarter.
They're lined up almost like they're going to be an offense kick. Look at that. And maybe have some other players in.
Patrick McGee's standing back on his own 10-yard line. Lolo Wheat is shallow. It is going to be a pooch kick again to Dalton McGee over on the far side. He'll field to the 35-yard line, get hit immediately, and brought down at the 36-yard line. So the
number 10 again, shoving.
The Cougars will get to start this first offensive series of the third quarter from their own 36-yard line. 37 looks like we're going to spot it. Ball spotted on the far side hash mark. If you're just joining us, the Cougars are dressed in the red jerseys with the yellow letters. And the Autauga Academy Generals are in the white jerseys.
With the predator-style helmets.
Tyree Smith going to be wide out to the near side. Chase Bell to the far side. Dahl from the shotgun. Throws back on screen pass. Lolo Wheat hit immediately as he catches the ball behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to be about a two-yard loss. Screen pass. Not quite picking up what we hoped it would. They're going to put this one back across that 35 to the 34-yard line.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say their defense is probably number one in the state.
They've got several defenders that are already got offers. So. Mm.
Twins on the near side, single line out the far side. Now, Lolo Wheat in motion towards that far side. Dahl from the shotgun, flanked to his right by Patrick McGee. Hands off to McGee. Up the middle, he bounces around. Got a little room, one man to beat. Pushes, stiffs arms, and gets run out of bounds at the what's that, the 43-yard line. He'll pick up maybe 7-8 on that play.
Third and five.
Third down, five. Cougars definitely needing to convert this third down. It looks like Lolo Wheat and Chase Bell is going wide out on the far side. We have Tyree Smith wide out on the near side. Dahl from the shotgun. Patrick McGee flanks to his right. Here's a snap. Dahl looking to pass immediately. Quick. Hits Bell over at the line of scrimmage. Bell catches it, moves forward, plows across near that 50-yard line. Didn't quite cross it. Looks like he's going to get stopped at the spotting at the 49-yard line. That's enough for the first down, though. Cougars will move the chains and get another set of downs to work with. First and 10 from their own 49-yard line. Dahl looking back at Coach, trying to get his call. Looks like Tyree Smith's going to be wide out near side. Far side's going to be Lolo Wheat and Chase Bell. Patrick McGee is going to be flanking Dahl to his left this time. Dahl from the shotgun. Now he's back and behind him. The play clock will expire. Nope, I think they called timeout prior to the play clock expiration. So Escambia Academy has to use their first timeout to prevent that delay of game from occurring. So that takes 60 seconds. Talk about it. We'll take 60 seconds to go back to WBZR 105.9. Have really low volume. All right, we're back. First and 10 on the 49. The Cougars have it. Twins far side, single line out near side. Dahl from the shotgun. Here's a snap. Dahl's going to keep it, bring it around the near side. Got a couple men to beat. Try to get to the line of scrimmage. Makes it to the line of scrimmage. That's about it, though. He's run out of bounds. At the 49-yard line, that's going to be no gain. That'll bring up second down and 10. Ball standing on the 49-yard line. He'll pick up a half a yard, so it's 49 and a half yard line.
And one on the play, second and nine at the 50-yard line.
Nose of the ball about 2 inches from touching the 50-yard line. Chase Bell and Lolo Wheat wide out the far side. Tyree Smith near side, Dahl from the shotgun. Dahl looking, calling for it. Calls for Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee is hit in the backfield as soon as he touches the ball. Brought down around the 38-yard line. Big time loss, but looks like they're going to spot it way back up there where Patrick actually touched the ball, giving him forward progress. That'll be a loss of five.
Loss of six on the play. Third 15.
Third down, 15. Ball now on the 44-yard line. Clock's ticking. 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. Autauga up by 28. Dalton McGee in the wide out this time as well. We have Tyree Smith and Dalton McGee on this on the near side. That's Lolo Wheat and Chase Bell on the far side. Delay of game is called against the Cougars. Back about 5 yards. I'll make a third down and 20.
That's a stat I'd like to see. Penalty yardage. Maybe I wouldn't like to see it.
I don't think I would either. From the spread formation.
Tell me, we lost power up here.
Dahl from the shotgun, calling for it. Looking to pass in the pocket, got pressure, rolling out the far side. That's pressure, he's gonna keep it. This time and run across, stays on his feet, gets nailed at the 42-yard line. He'll pick up about four. Was brought down, but it's way shy of the first down.
And a ball on the play to the Escambia 43-yard line.
I'll bring up fourth down and 16. Cameron Bowen, I have to punt it away. Otago's punt receiving team has put the pressure on Cameron Bowen each time. Coming again, Bowen gets it off. It's end over end punt. Gonna hit at the 30, bounce to the 20. It's gonna be picked up. Run down the far side end. Far side was knocked out around the 35-yard line. Looks like that's Chase Bell that knocked him out of bounds.
Autauga will take over at the 33-yard line.
Referee's actually gonna spot it at the 33, so it's gonna be first down and 10, Autauga from their own 33-yard line. 8 minutes, 23 seconds. Showing the clock, third quarter. Trip car. In the quarterback. From the shotgun, twins on the near side. Car, hands off to his running back. Tries to bring it across the near side. In and tries to... Didn't like that, cut it back in, gets hit by half the Cougar team and brought down, but he'll pick up maybe five or six in the play. They're gonna spot it on the 39-yard line. That was a 6-yard gain, so it's a second down and four. Ball on the 39, 7 minutes, 53 seconds. Twins on the near side, single line out of the far side. Carr from the shotgun, flanked to his left by his running back. That's number 11, Trey Cutler. Hands off to Cutler. Cutler takes around the far side end. Gets clipped by number 2, Chase Bell, where he goes down hard. But it's going to pick up the first down. Right around the 46-yard line. That's spotting back across the 45 to the 43-yard line. Still enough for the first down. Close, may measure this one. It's pretty close. And they are. The officials are going to call timeout, bring the chains on the field to measure.
You need one of those.
Oh, I think.
Reminds me of our kicker last week. He's buttoned all on up. Toboggan and all.
Yeah, he was. Like bringing the chains on, they'll measure this.
He just.
That was close. Jordan, what do you think from your angle?
I think it's going to be maybe just short. If you're going to leave that spot there.
Gonna be one or the other.
That's a good point.
just short. I think George's right.
Hey.
Inches. So it's going to be third down and less than one to go. It's going to be maybe 6 inches, I would say. All right, so Generals have it. Twin, single wide out near side, single wide out far side. Carr handing off up the middle to Carr. No, he fakes it. Play action, throws deep. Gets in his car. Oh, no, it was almost right. Caught, but Chase Bell ripped it out of his hand. Great defensive play by Chase Bell. Number one was the intended receiver. That was Carson Tate.
Now, if you're them, would you go for it here?
Not by 28.
That's my question.
They're definitely going for it.
They're going to go for it. They're going to do a quick pass because we're not set. Nobody's throwing numbers.
They're going to send the Trey Cutler up the middle. Cutler's a big man.
They should run a slant right there on the outside.
There we go. Cougars going to blitz and hit him in the backfield, and they are going to stop
him. That's a good stop.
Cougars make a strong defensive hold.
Yeah, we need that.
And we'll take over on downs. Right around the 40-yard line. Great defensive play. Cougars showed late blitz. As soon as the snap came through, about half the team was sitting in the backfield waiting on them. I think Coach Fountain was thinking the same thing we were. First down and 10, Cougars now from the 42-yard line. From the general side of the field. Chase Bell, wide out far side. Tyree Smith, a little weak, wide out near side. Dahl from the shotgun. Patrick McGee's going to flank him. Hutch is going to move, flank him to his left. Dahl calling for it. Low snap, Law looking fast, quick.
Oh.
Almost picked off by number 28.
We want the pass interference call. It's not getting it. They haven't called it all night. I'm going to start calling it now.
Dahl looking for that quick screen pass. Throws it over towards Lolo Wheat.
28 just saw it coming.
Cornerback saw it coming. That was number 28 from Autauga. Good read. That was Shamar Petaway. Second down, 10. Twins on the near side. Single wide out the far side. Dahl from the shotgun. Here's a snap. Hands to Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee's going to get his the line of scrimmage. Fight forward with everything he had to get back to the line of scrimmage for no gain.
He's got this little hop tonight that I'm not used to seeing, and I don't know if he's trying to just throw off the big guys on the line. That hop's taking a second or two away from his normal jump. And they're standing there waiting on.
Actually, they're showing a loss on that play of about one, so it's going to be third down and 11 with the ball sitting on the 43-yard line. Chase Bell by himself out to the far side. Lolo Wheat and Tyree Smith wide out the near side. Dahl, shotgun, Patrick McGee flanking to the left. Patrick McGee hands off to Patrick, and he goes across that far side tackle.
Ball is lost again.
Looks like the ball may have come out, and generals say they have it. We'll let the officials make the call.
Well, they're going to give it to
them. Officials say it was them.
Bring out Bowen to kick.
Fourth down, 10 from the 42-yard line. Cameron Bowen wants to punt it away once again. Bowen will be standing back on his own 44-yard line. Bowen called for it. Here's a snap. Good snap. Good kick. Kick is up. Oh, yeah, actually, it gets flanked to the right. It bounces. I think it bounces just in inbounds at the 26, maybe.
25, 24, somewhere in there.
Not responding.
No, not anymore.
Yeah, it's fine. That's part of the system. I don't want.
I can't even get rid of it.
What are you trying to do? High out?
No. Trying to update the yardage, but it doesn't go anywhere.
Yeah, that's part of why I don't like the NFHS system. That software is flaky at best.
Mm. Our Generals first and 10 from their own 28-yard line. Carr looking to pass. Throwing deep, looking deep. And great coverage by number one, Lolo Wheat. Incomplete pass. Ball was overthrown.
Flag over here.
Where's the flag?
32-yard
line. Flag on the 32-yard line. Looks like a false start against the Generals. That'll back them up. That'll get almost 5 yards. Let's keep it first down, though. First down of 15. 5 minutes, 15 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Autauga still leading 28-0. General showing twins on the near side. From the shotgun, Carr hands off. Oh, no.
Play action.
Handoff. Play action. Hits number five across on the slant. And he's going to break free. He's taking it to the house. Crosses the 20 to the 10 and walk in for the touchdown. That was a pass to number five, Turner Payton.
I love slants. They're deadly.
Played us, hurt us tonight, big time. That's going to extend their Autauga's lead 34-0. 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Not what we was hoping to see.
Score doesn't update anymore either.
Yeah, NFHS is just locked.
Yeah.
It's like Autauga's going to attempt the point after this time.
Why won't he?
Number three, Luke Palmer. To kick. Flag is thrown. False start against the Generals. That'll back them up 5 yards.
Should the score stay this way, Autauga walk away with the win. Still made it to state.
Yeah.
3 years in a row.
Getting there is half the battle.
Kick up. Almost blocked, but it's good. That extends the lead. Autauga 35. Escambia Academy 0. 5 minutes on the clock for the third quarter. If the Academy's going to do anything, they better do it now.
Clock will start spinning really fast in the next 5 minutes.
Autauga will get set to kick it away. Autauga hasn't kicked it deep all night. Every time they've kicked a little pooch kick, somewhere around the 40, 35-yard line. Patrick McGee is back deep. Lolo Wheat, not quite as deep, it's a 25-yard line. Ball's been coming to Dodger McGee. And it looks like that's where it's going to go this time. Docker is going to catch it at the 25-yard line, bring it across the field, tries to go up midfield, turns back, stays on his feet, and fights forward out to the 34-yard line where he's brought down.
Saw a flag.
As the flag comes out.
I didn't see the reason. It's on us.
It's on us.
I think it's a holding call against us. Well, that'll back them up 10 yards. All right, so Timmy Academy will start. First and 10 now from their own 23-yard line. Tyree Smith wide out on the near side with Lolo Wheat. Chase Bell's wide out on the far side.
And 12 men.
12 men on the field.
12 men was on the field. Looks like that was number 9, Cameron Bowen, trying to get off the field quickly, but Not quite quick enough. Got to back him up. Ball on the 19-yard line now. This time, ball goes under center. Backs I formation. Hands off to Jabo. Hits the line of scrimmage and brought down behind the line of scrimmage. With the forward progress, it gets out to the 20.
1 yard on the play, second 14, 14.
1 yard gain, that's second 14. 4 minutes, 29 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Twins near side, single wide out far side. Dahl under center with the backs in the I formation. Chase Bell now in motion to the near side. Tall sweep to Patrick McGee around the near side, hitting the backfield, fights forward, gets across the line of scrimmage. He'll pick up about two before he's brought down.
Gain of 3 yards, third 11.
Well, spotted on the 23-yard line. That's going to be third down now in 11. 3 minutes, 45 seconds on the clock, third quarter.
Their defense does a real good job of limiting big plays.
Yeah. They set up a wall up there and there's no getting through it.
General showing blitz this time. It's a toss sweep to Patrick. Patrick's looking to throw this time. No. I'm going to have to keep it. He's tiptoeing down and throws it across the middle trying to hit Chase Bell.
He might have been across the line of scrimmage. I think he was. Yep. I think that's what that flag's going to be.
Flag's out. Bring up fourth down. Cougars have to punt away once again deep from their own territory, well deep in their own territory. The ball is now placed at the 21-yard line. Cameron Bowen standing on his own six.
Gotta be quick. Don't hold on to it.
General's trying to put the pressure to block. Here's the kick is up and it's spiraling. It's going to be caught at the 45, dropped, picked up. Number seven going to take it back across the field and the flag comes out. Two
another
flags
flag
comes out. Seven takes it all the way down. He cuts it back across the 20 to the 15, the 10. He's going to look like he's taking this one in. Number seven's going to run this one back into the end zone. It looks like there's three flags on the field, so it looks like this one probably is coming back on the holding call.
The refs are pointing that direction.
Holding
yep.
is called against the Generals. This one's coming back.
I will mention, you got our roster handy?
I do.
Take a look here.
That's
yours. Seniors, Pat D, Cameron Bowen, Jay Dahl, Sam Martin, Rebel Mitchell, Brandon Goldsby, and Nolan Lyon are only seniors. We're not losing a whole team next year. We'll lose six or seven players, of which that's definitely some talent. Pat's, of course, a great all-around player, but far from being over in the
court. General showing trips on the far side, single wide out near side. Carr taking a snap, looking to pass deep in the pocket, throwing downfield. Got a man open in the flats, hits him. That's number five.
He nice move.
Tackles and plows over to the 42-yard line where he's finally brought down. 43-yard line, looks like. First down, 10. Generals. Ball on the 43, Cougars side of the field.
Over here, we had no trips over here.
Trips on the near side, quick snap. Looking to pass, throwing quick. And Patrick, just, no, that's Lolo Week, just nails him after he catches the ball, but it's complete for another first down. There's a flag on the play, though. Let's see what that's about.
Lucky that's all that was. It was a first down, if it stands.
It's against, I think it's going to be against the general this time. This one's coming back. Beat up 35 to nothing. Autauga still is not taking their foot off the gas at all.
No. They seem to be a very aggressive team. Yeah. I think that last touchdown was their first extra point. They went for two every other time.
First down and 15. Followed on the Cougar 48. Tava showing trips on the near side, single wide out far side. Carr from the shotgun. Back in the pocket, the pass. Now rolling out to the near side, looking deep. Throwing number five again, Peyton. Oh. It's going to be broke up by Dalton McGee. Good job by Dalton. Dalton McGee having to fight that one all the way down to prevent that potential touchdown.
That's good. Good coverage.
Incomplete pass brings up second down to 15. Balls on the 48-yard line. We got 2 minutes, 21 seconds left in the third quarter.
Tim, I think your NFHS stream is completely down.
Yeah, well, I'm surprised there.
Yep. And anyone who was using it didn't have a scoreboard update for the last quarter.
On the shotgun, pro set formation. Carr looking to pass, throw it across the middle again, hits the number three, number five. I don't know who we were going after. They're both in the same vicinity. But number two, Chase Bell, just tattooed number three as he was going for the ball. That was number 33 going for the ball, the intended receiver. He didn't catch the ball, but he's not going to forget the hit Chase Bell just gave him.
Third down
15, ball on the 48-yard line. 2 minutes, 21 seconds. Trips near side, single wide out far side. Carr from the shotgun, flanked to his right by his running back. Here's a snap, Carr looking to pass, looking deep. Throwing
five's
number
wide
five's
open.
Wide open if he catches it. He walks in the end zone with that complete pass. There wasn't a Cougar player within 10 yards of number five, Peyton. That was Turner Peyton. Wide open. Catches the ball, walks in the end zone to bring Autauga up to 41 points. Autauga will now go for two. Yeah.
I think they're kicking.
No, they're kicking. You're right.
Oh, we're going to be all sides. Kick it anyhow. And
ball start is actually on the target. Must have been some motion on that offensive line early. And we couldn't see from our angle. Two minutes, 9 seconds on the clock. Second attempt at that point after. Here's a snap, kick up, and kick's going to be good. It's going to just drop over the...
Might be an offsides call.
Flag in?
I don't know. I heard a lot.
Yeah, over here on the number 10.
It's going to be good, though.
Yeah, I think
so. Good. That makes the score. Autauga 42 is Escambia Academy 0. Okay. 2 minutes, 9 seconds left to go in the third quarter.
And a total yardage is just looking worse.
Yardage is killing us. Yeah. You got Autauga has 446 yards. We have 111. They have 180 rushing. We have 70. And it's
267 to 41.
I mean, and we're leaving them wide open. I mean, it's a championship game. You can't leave a player wide open. I'm not sure if he tripped up or what was going on. But it'll be interesting to see who Autauga's quarterback will be next year. Triple graduate out. They're losing several seniors.
It's a pretty big loss.
It is a big loss.
Yeah, Tripp's arm has been quite impressive. His ability to scramble is unmatched by many. Coming another pooch kick over to Dalton McGee. Nope, Chase Bell's going to take this one. He takes it down the far side. Sideline, he gets run out of bounds around midfield.
Still a great season.
It has been. I mean,
we've had some really good games. Blown some people out. Took on a couple of larger schools this year to test us out. Battery for that.
Escambia Academy has made it to the state final championship game 3 years in a row. Autauga, and they played Autauga all three times. Autauga won it the first time. Academy won it the second time. Autauga's won it. It looks like they're going to win this time. Unless something drastic changes in the next quarter and 2 minutes. Timeout's going to be called on the field by the Cougars. Coach Mountain wants to talk to him a second. We're going to take 60 seconds along with them. Head back to WBZR 105.9. Cougar ball, first down and 10 on the own 43-yard line with 2 minutes, 3 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Tyree Smith wide out near side, takes Pell to the far side. Dahl from under center, backs in the I formation. Hands off to Dodger McGee. He crosses that right side tackle. He'll pick up about 3-4 he's brought down. Number 4 on that play. They're going to spot it on that 47-yard line, far side hash mark. Second down and 6, ball's on 47. 1 minute, 36 seconds on the third quarter. Jabo Davis and Dalton McGee are in running backs. Tyree Smith was wide out to the near side. That's Chase Bell wide out on the far side. Dahl from under center this time. Play clock expires right at the time the ball snaps. Flags come out. That's going to be delay of game is the call.
Penalties, penalties, penalties.
Ball's now going to be on the 42-yard line. Second down and 11. Dahl approaching the line of scrimmage. Staying in the same formation. Here's a snap. Hands off to Daughtry McGee across the far side end. Daughtry's going to take it out to the 49-yard line where he's brought down. That's a 6-yard gain for Dr. McGee. And Dr. McGee will be back for 2 more years. He's in 10th grade, right?
Number 2 is limping off.
Chase Bell's got a little bit of a tweak in his leg. He's going to come out.
Chase Bell's coming off. Looks like Sam Fields is going in for Bell.
Yeah, we're going to be losing 5 or 6 seniors. JV went undefeated last year. It's going to be another good year.
Dockery's hit, trying to spin loose.
He's not Stay down. On his feet. He wasn't down. Come on, let him play the ball.
Well, the ball is more on dead. Dockery McGee never down, still spinning at all points in time.
Would have been a touchdown if we could have not had the whistle blowing prematurely.
Yeah, it's more common with quarterbacks for him to blow that whistle early, you know.
Fourth down, 3 yards to go. Ball is on the 50-yard line.
Isn't listed on team. On technical list. Seniors again. Nolan Lyman, number 54, senior. Brandon Goldsby, senior. Reverend Mitchell, senior. Joan Taylor, senior. Sam Martin, our kicker, our extra point kicker, senior. J. Dahl, quarterback, senior. Cameron Bowen, senior. Pat McGee, senior. We're losing 8 seniors on a team that, although a lot of these guys on the sideline haven't got a lot of play time tonight, they've got a lot of play time during the JV, and went undefeated. So
that's a good sign.
We've had some visits recently by some new kids. We usually pick up additional kids around Christmas time. And I would imagine we're going to be back here next year. Maybe we can get Jordan to come back.
That'll do it for the third quarter. Start the fourth quarter. Autauga will go in the fourth quarter, leading 42-0 over Escambia Academy. Academy now having to punt it away. Cameron Bowen back, kicking.
Super high.
End over end kick, gonna be bounced at the 23. Take the Cougar roll across the 20, the 19, 18, to the, all the way down to the 11-yard line for it.
Autauga will take over.
Touch dead by Dodger McGee. Autauga will take it. First down and 10 from their own 11-yard line. 11 minutes, 23 seconds, the clock running.
You guys are right, though. You don't want to take away from the season. The season was still really good.
Yeah.
I mean, you're here.
Fabulous
so.
Season. I don't have the stats with me. Regional champions, obviously, in our region.
Anytime you make it all the way to this championship game, it looks like Carr trying to keep it himself. Staying on his feet, and he finally knocked out around the 20-yard line. Right at the first down marker. I don't know exactly where they're going to spot it. We're just short.
Just short.
I will say, 2014 was the first year EA ever won a state championship, and that was under the coaching of Hugh Houghton. 15, I think we were knocked out in semis. 16, we lost against Autauga. 17, we won against Autauga, and we're here again.
Mm-hmm.
So he's doing something right, not only as the head manager, but also as the AD.
Definitely cannot hang your head down with that tight record. At Escambia Academy. Gain of 6, that's going to be first down and 10 for the Generals at the 26-yard line. 9 minutes, 52 seconds left to go in the game. Twins now showing on the far side. Carr from the shotgun, hands off up the middle. Gets hit in the backfield and brought down by number 68. And that is that's Tyler Newton. Ball on the 25-yard line. Second down, 11. General Sabbath, Twins on the far side. Carr from the shotgun. Behind him is number 11, is big Trey Cutler, a big running back, 275-pound running back.
Quick on those wheels.
And no, thanks to Play Cutler action. Looking to pass. Got a
deep.
Man open downfield. Was tripped up.
He fell
Looks
down.
Like Lalo, we could intercept it. No, not quite. Lilo, he was the only man that was possible to catch that ball after the intended receiver tripped on over his own feet.
They're showing the aggression again. Play action deep.
Play action deep.
They don't take their feet off the gas.
No, sir.
You got to remember, Autauga's coming in here knowing they lost against us last year.
Yeah.
They've held that in their side, you know, a thorn in their side for a year. They've just come out and wanted it more.
Twins far side. Carr looking to pass. Got man on the slot looking deep again. Same position, same play. It's caught at
good
the 30-yard line and brought down.
It's a good catch.
Big pass, big catch. First down and 10 now inside Cougar territory to the 30-yard line. 7 minutes, 49 seconds left on the clock in the game.
Can't take anything from Trick Carr. Passed 10,000 plus yards in his high school season. He is first one in the AISA tour. Was fifth overall in the state. He's got an arm. I mean, it's just...
Well, he's going to leave here at the championship game with 300-yard passing.
Easy. That's 13 plus.
Yeah, 506 total yards so far. Twins near side. Carr, shotgun, hands off to Cutler up the middle. Cutler hit, kept on, stayed on his feet. Finally brought down at the 31-yard line.
Number 14, Brady Howe. 35, Jabo Davis. Number 8, Patrick McGee and somebody else.
That's a two-yard loss. Nope. They put the ball back at 29, so it's no gain.
Coming up next after us, of course, we won't be broadcasting. It's going to be Bessemer against Monroe.
That'll be a good game.
Bessemer, you know, we took on earlier in the season and came up short against them. Monroe and Bessemer are 3A school. For those watching who don't know, EA and Autauga are 2A school.
Carr this time handing off to Cutler as he goes around the far side end. Hit, missed, hit, stayed on his feet, hit again, and finally is knocked out of bounds and tripped up at the 8-yard line. Looks like maybe 10-yard line where he's spotting it. Cutler is a big man. Once you get him rolling, it's hard to bring him down.
He's like having a fullback on a faster.
For those of you joining, if you were watching the NFHS earlier, it crashed on us, and that's pretty much what I'm going to do with that system.
First,
I think we'll be using it next year.
First down and goal from the 10-yard line. Generals have it. With 6 minutes left to go on the clock. Spread formation this time. Carr has it. Hands off to number 20. 20 takes it around the far side end. Cuts back in. Breaks the plane. Touchdown, Generals. 48-0. Current score. 5 minutes, 41 seconds. Left to go in the game. Autauga going to attempt the point after. Number 3, Luke Palmer. Set to kick it.
Oh, we're way offside.
Kicked up, kicked good. Autauga extends their lead to 49-0.
5 minutes remaining. Clock is running.
The clock doesn't stop.
In the fourth quarter.
It don't need to stop today.
Long, long game. They started off in that first quarter and just haven't been able to catch up.
They were right out the gate and they just...
I don't know of a game that we've been kept under 0.3 yards. I just don't know of one. I mean, between Pat's... Let's talk about Pat's game last week. There's a discussion of 397 yards or 405. He still had 397 yards, six touchdowns. Tonight, we've had 82. Can't do that. I mean, it's just not going to equal points.
Well, Autauga's defense has been just phenomenal tonight. It's pretty much shut everything down.
Kind of reminds me of last year with Jamie Welker. I could go on the list of those kids have gone on to play college level for us. I actually saw Jamie and Fred earlier today. It was nice to see them. I asked them if they wanted to suit up.
pooch kick. This time going to be received by Lolo Wheat. Going down that far side, he gets knocked down right around the 42-yard line.
Escambia will take over possession at the 43-yard line.
First and 10 from their own 43 is where Escambia Academy will start this series. 3 minutes, 23 seconds left on the clock. The clock is ticking.
It'd be nice to seal the deal with some points.
Some points on the board.
I would love to see some points on the board. Dahl going under center.
J-Bo and Pat line.
In the I formation, so Dahl's going to take the snap. Toss sweep Patrick McGee around the. He's actually cuts it back, tries to go over tackle, stays on his feet, still on his feet driving while the, half the team is trying to bring him down all the way out to the 49-yard line. There's a flag come flying.
I didn't see it. I was zoomed in on the action on the field.
Patrick McGee gained 6 on that play. Let's see if we can tack on some more or we're going to take away them 6. Looks
it's
like
on
us. Taking them away.
Just can't. It's been an issue all season. Let's just be honest with ourselves. I mean,
penalties have, yeah.
Senseless penalties. Something, you know, that they'll definitely work on over season.
Must have been a holding call. Still first down, 15, ball's on 38.
Snap the ball before he gets off the field. Nope.
Dahl handing off Patrick McGee. Patrick McGee brings it around the near side tackle. He's hit at the line of scrimmage and brought down.
2 minutes.
2 minutes left to go in the game. Patrick's hurt. We'll take a moment to see.
Unfortunately, we've got all kinds of medical staff up here. And Troy. Could be cramping, could be just gassed. Been driving and having some big fellas on him all night long.
See if you can replay there, Tim, and see if we can see.
I can at this point. Once we go beyond like a minute or 30 seconds, I can't go back easily. Hoping to get that fixed for next year. Looks like he's about to stand up. Okay, they're taking Pat's helmet off. And those on Facebook, yeah, we don't have the
camera
on that.
He's coming up.
He is up.
Yeah. Favoring that right leg, though. Excuse me, left leg. Uh-oh. That don't look good for Patrick.
He's not even putting pressure on that left leg.
Nothing on that left leg.
Pat has had an excellent career. Yeah, had several big guys. I say big guys. Had other runners in front of him his freshman year with Tiff Brown. The next year he had Trey Turner from him. But Pat is an excellent character. Already had multiple visits. He's not done playing football. I'll tell you that right now.
Hopefully that injury's not as bad as it looked to have him limping off like that.
Looking at him now on the sideline. He's sitting. All right, we're back in action.
Off from under center now. Cameron Bowen in motion to the far side. Hands off to Daughtry. Daughtry comes across, ducks a man, and tries to go under him, but he gets caught and brought down. It's a 2 yard gain, it looks like. Third down and 9. 1 minute, 19 seconds left to go in the ball game. Oh, Dahl taking his time walking to the line of scrimmage. J-Ro Davis and Dr. McGee in the running backs. Wide out to the far side and near side. Hands off to Daughtry right up the middle. Daughtry gets hit and spins. And the whole, everybody on the field is piled up trying to push. Finally, the referees will call it dead. Had to pick up maybe 4 yards. Fourth down now on the 49-yard line.
Might not run another play.
30 more seconds left to go.
I don't think he has one on his upright.
I'd let it go down to about...
He's going to let it run down.
Let it run down about 2 seconds. That's going to be it.
16 seconds remaining. What a season. State runner-up. Can't take anything away from that.
No, not at all.
You have naysayers say that, you know, they didn't win, yada, yada. The state runners-up for a team lost several seniors last year. Only won about 8 this year.
It's every team's goal to be in this game. So
every team's goal to be in the state championship. Everybody's love to win. My wife just says the best team. Gotta be a winner, gotta be a loser, and this time we walk away the loser. Gotta give it to Autauga. What a defense.
And the offense, really just all phases. They came out ready to go.
They did. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, but I'm very proud of our Cougars. They've come a long way this year and have just done an excellent job all year long. Made it to the state championship game. There's nothing to hang your head on when you make it to the state championship game.
Definitely. Not at all.
Especially not multiple years in a row. This has been a phenomenal team.
To win in 14 is 3A, drop down to 2A, make it back 16 to semis, or actually 16 made it back up here, lost to Autauga, come back in 17, win against Autauga, and this year they had the upper advantage and they'll walk away with a shinier trophy than ours. We're still going to bring a shiny trophy home, just not as shiny. Have some kind of look at it. So we're not going to go offline yet, folks. We're going to go ahead and keep the film rolling. We're going to watch Autauga. We'll actually receive the runners-up trophy first. Second in the AISA system, 2A. Of course, then you want to watch Autauga this year. Different kind of from last year. Last year, I was running down the field with my camera. Different kind of momentum this year. But
hey, you were prepared to do it this year.
I was prepared, folks. Y'all should see some technology we had up here. I was ready to go to the field.
And you would now directly take it to the center of the field.
Sombering moment. Is that the right word? Sombering? Is that a...
Yes.
Senorita, that's a drink.
No, that works. Sobering?
Definitely excitement. I know that feeling from last year. Trip Carr's son, being the quarterback, I know he's excited to have coached his son for 12, you know, however many years he's been playing football. Glad to see him. He's over here right now, folks. I mean, I'm sorry. He's hugging these players. He loves a coach. Great coach. I mean, you can't knock that team. Great effort. Came with a great game plan. And they're going to go home state champions this year.
Well, that's going in doing it for the 2018 Escambia Academy football season. Before we final dismiss, we'll say one more last thank you to our sponsors. That's Alabama Tank, Johnson Ford, the United Bank, Dewar Technology, Dr. William Harris, General Surgeon, Superior Petroleum Services, Reynolds Real Estate, Diamond Gasoline, David's Catfish House, and David's Paint and Body. Go by and see them. Tell them thank you for making it possible for us to bring this live broadcast to you every week. This is Ben White along with Tim Dewar, and tonight along with Jordan Teak, bringing the last broadcast of the 2018 season. We will see y'all next year. Go Cougars.
No doubt.
Go Cougars.